Well, thank you very much. I want to know what you think, America. Give me a call at 1-800-522-8673. Tonight's guest has served as a human caution light along Madison Avenue for years on his countless HBO specials. His new book, Napalm and Silly Putty, currently tops the New York Times bestseller list. Well, if there is a Mount Rushmore, his is certainly the first face in comedy. Please welcome George Carlin, ladies and gentlemen. This is not having a foolish shit bone in your body pays off because these people. How long have you been doing comedy now, Georgie?
If you count being in radio 4 years, which I do, 44 years.
44
yeah,
years.
2 years with a partner. Yeah. And getting better, I think.
I watch your specials and I think, how does this fucking guy get it up like this?
Well, you know. It's an old saying, if you do something for 44 years, you better be getting better at it. You better be improving somewhere. But anyway, it's more fun than ever. That's really what I kind of meant.
And what's with you're like ripped. How old are you now? You're 60?
I'm 64, which is 17 Celsius. Which, in Canada, I'm kind of late adolescent, which is sort of what I am anyway.
Now, George, what about advertising? Why do you think it's so effective? I'm always amazed it's effective in this culture, aren't you? When you watch it, you sort of go, I could appreciate that ad, but certainly doesn't seem to stimulate me. Why do you think it works on people?
I think people are stupid. I think it's really, it's pretty fundamental. People are stupid and easily manipulated, you know. And the American people are really pretty stupid. And I don't mean these people here tonight. This is a different group. I mean the ones that didn't get here. The ones that didn't get here.
They found their way into the studio.
Last week's people.
Though. Yeah, exactly.
But it's just, you know, you hear this canard that the politicians roll this one out a couple times a week. The American people are far more intelligent than they're given credit for. And I think that's 180 degrees out of whack. I think they're far less intelligent than they're given credit for. H.L. Mencken said, no one ever went broke underestimating the intelligence of the American public. And it's true. The things that, and if you need proof, you just listen to talk radio, read the letters to the editor, listen to the answers when someone with a microphone approaches someone. There's a famous poll that you've heard quoted, everyone has.
Like Willessa.
This is a, no.
Oh,
I'm sorry. You gotta listen with your eyes to this guy.
I'm sorry.
No, that's fine, but a very close relative of his. There's a famous poll that was that's quoted a lot. It's I don't know what it proves. It's about 20 years old now, so forgive the age of it. But they said, who is the most trusted person? Who do you trust the most in this country? And Walter Cronkite won this poll. People said, Walter fucking Cronkite. This is a newsreader for a commercial network. But the interesting thing is who came in second. Betty Crocker, okay? Betty fucking Crocker, a fictional person, a lady from the front of a cookie box, the second most trusted person. And the kind of things people believe, these are good figures. One of these is MIT, the other one's Northern Illinois University polls, more recent. 67% of the people believe in angels, okay? Now you have to kind of keep in mind what that means. Two out of every three people believe that there's kind of a thing flipping around nearby who's going to help them out in a bus accident, you know? 78% believe in hell, that there's an eternal punishment place that you're sent if you don't follow certain rules. It's just amazing. And conversely, there's no respect for real intellect. People are marginalized in high school, especially in high school. It's famous. People are called nerds. Anyone who uses their brain, follows their intellect, wants to pursue something intelligent, is a nerd, a geek, an egghead, or a grind. To me, it's just the fact that people don't use their brains, that I don't, they're not very intelligent to start with or something. I don't know.
Weren't you in the service when you were young, George?
Yeah, I was.
And when they gave you all that officer and a gentleman bullshit where sit-ups in the mud will help you become a man. Did you question everything? You must have been the like quintessential ball buster.
Well, I was, I was breaking balls before that. I had already left three schools, you know, by mutual agreement. It's not working out. And been kicked out of the Boy Scouts and the choir and the old boys for the Air Force was an easy one to get out of. But talk about intellect. I joined the Air Force to stay out of the service. How do you like that? Because it's not really real in the Air Force. It's like a big country club, you know. But I don't know.
Why do you think people are so easily influenced? Besides
being stupid.
Yeah, I mean, stupid is your core underlay. But what are some of the other things?
They're superstitious. Yeah. They have these beliefs, these primitive, you know. People believe in, they're just really kind of credulous and gullible. People believe in, for instance, hell and angels, okay? These are very primitive, very, very backward to me, backward-sounding beliefs. These are childlike, and that's the key, because they get you when you're a kid. They get you when you're little, and they tell you there's a God. And if you can make people believe, I believe this, if you can make someone believe that there's an invisible man living in the sky who's watching everything you do and keeping count of everything you do, which is good and which is bad, then you can make that person believe anything after that. You can add anything you want. The 4th of July shit just rolls right in. Land of the free, home of the brave, the press is fair and impartial, justice is blind, all men are created equal, your vote is important, the United States government is on your side, the army is here to keep the peace, the police are on your side, and your vote is important. Did I say that? Oh, and freedom of choice. This is the big one. The illusion of choice. They were led to feel free by the exercise of meaningless choices. There are, for instance, important things, not too many choices. Unimportant things, ice cream flavors, what do you want? We got 31. Got the flavor of the week, got the flavor of the month. But political parties, we're down to two. Jeez. Yeah, and Jesse Ventura from, sources of information. Media companies down to five or six now. Banks, insurance companies, pharmaceuticals, chemical companies, oil companies. Used to be seven, down to three now. Pretty soon going to be two. But if you're looking for a bagel or a fucking donut, hey, what do you want? Pineapple supreme hazelnut. We got everything you want. Cereals. I counted personally in the store, counted 192 different cereal choices. 192. 140 different cat foods. I counted them. 140. And that includes a tartar-controlled cat food for senior citizen cats, okay? And one more.
George, now, let me ask you, you're so bright, and you're so skeptical, and you're 64 now. Have you managed to find a place where you can be at peace? Or I'm 47. I still find all this shit maddening. You say things. Yeah. Obviously, your stock and trade has always been the brilliant thing in the guise of a joke. But it's so true, and I get so pissed off sometimes. Where, have you found a way to get your head around it?
Well, the only thing I found that I do, that I did long range, long term, some years back, was to live outside of it all. Just to decide, well, I have to participate at some level, but I'll stay out here on the Oort cloud, just outside the solar system, aiming comets at these people, and I'll watch it all like the circus it is. When you're born, you get a ticket to the freak show. I say, enjoy the show. Don't take it seriously. Sit back, watch the show.
Yoda, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around, George.